बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द कॉन्सेप्ट फॉर द यूटिलिटी थ्योरी और यूटिलिटी वैल्यूज, यूटिलिटी फंक्शन। वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट दैट व्हाट इज इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टी फॉर द यूटिलिटीज आर इट विल कंसीडर बोथ, दैट इज नंबर वन द बिहेवियर ऑफ और लाइफ स्टाइल ऑफ द डिसीजन मेकर, नंबर टू the probability that is the expected value. So it means with the use in the utility, both of the previous features they are included. Moreover, as we were discussing that the how can we determine the utility value of the payoff, that okay, that suppose we were given to answer these questions, we were given as the minimum value along with the probability will be given, the minimum and the maximum value will be given as along with the probability. For example, let me show you. So what value of P, so what value of P should make in difference between the two situation? It means the first give the previous thing so that will be more clear, otherwise you may have the problem. Where it is. So here, yes, suppose you are given the option to select one of the following two alternatives. Number one, that is either you were given is Rij, that is one of the payoff value for the surety. It means when we give us the value something about the surety, it means it does not include about the probability. Surety is the surety is the opposite of the surety, opposite of the probability. So either I've been given Rij, that is the some value in the surety, or more second option is we were given some of game of chance in which we will get the highest payoff maximum R along with the probability, or moreover with the lowest payoff with the R minimum with the 1 minus P is the 1 minus where P represent the probability. So that this will be shown as suppose we were given Rij with the value of the surety, or moreover if we were given as the minimum value with the probability 1 minus P and the maximum payoff value with the probability P. So might be because changing some of the value of the P, either this balance will be to the going to this side or this side. Well, maybe some value of P, this balance will be heavier going to the right. Some other value of P, this will be going to this side. So we need to identify what is the value of P for which these two will be are in difference or indifference or equal. So the answer to the question is the indifference probability for the P of Rij and is used for the utility value for the Rij, then this payoff value will be used for the utility of Rij. So in other words, we need to formulate the utility function for Rij for the surety is equal to P. We need to identify what is the value of P so that they were simple version, so that they are, these two are balanced to each other. Now let's talk about the example. Is suppose we were given to suppose we have two alternatives over there, D1 and D2. We have the two states of the nature D, S1 and S2. So if we need to, then as the concept for the utility is what is the minimum value here? We have four values over there: minus 50, 150, 100, minus 50, minus 100. What is the minimum value? The minimum value is minus 50. Minimum value is minus 50. What is the maximum value? The maximum value is 150. Maximum value is 150. As we know in the previous, we know for the previous minimum value along with the probability, maximum value for the probability. Yes. The minimum value, the R minimum with the corresponding 1 minus P, R maximum with the corresponding P. So it means, yes, this is the in the balance here, alternate number one, we were given two alternate number one, in which we were given a surety of a surety event in which Rij is given as 100. On the other hand, alternate number 2, in which we were given a game of chance, we were given the maximum value and maximum payoff and the minimum payoff. For the maximum payoff, we were also given some value of the P and the minimum value, some value of the 1 minus P. Suppose, let me give you, suppose the P is given as it is sure, it means here we cannot change anything because the variable is P. Suppose P equals to, suppose P equals to 1, then how do we compute the expected value? 1 multiplied by 150. So if you are given P equal to 1, so P over 1, then this will be cancelled. For P equal to 1, this will be cancelled, and our corresponding value will be 150. For P equal to 1, you prefer 2. Why do you prefer 2? Because 150 is more than 100. Okay. Now let's say more. So as expected value, so as more of expected value along with the expected utility, the highest value will be given. Now let's talk about, suppose we were given P equal to 0. For P equal to 0, this value will be 0. And this equal to 1 minus equal to minus 50. Here we have minus 50. Okay. Here, and because minus 50 is less than 100, so we will prefer to alternate number 1. For P equal to 0, you prefer alternate number 1. Okay. Now let's just randomly check. For example, suppose I were given P equals 0.1. Suppose equal to P equal to, let's make 0.2, suppose. P equal to 0.2. Now we will compute for the alternate number 1 and alternate number 2. For alternate number 1, because the surety value will be the same 100, Rij is 100. For P equal to 0.2, then 0.2 multiplied by 150. But then the 1 is equal to 30. Then 0.2, 0.2 is equal to 0.8, 0.8 multiplied by 50. Then is equal to minus 0.2. It is equal to 0.8. 0.8 multiplied by minus 50. So while solving for this one, we will solve for this one. So let me 0.2 multiply by 50. 0.2 is 15, 30 says. Then 0.8 multiplied by. So solving for this one, it is equal to, I think it is equal to 30 plus equal to 30 minus minus plus 8 times 40 for 70, value equal to 70. So again, if we will, it means for the optimal decision, we will go for the alternate number 1. So in the same way, for different value of P, either we will select 1, alternate number 1 or alternate number 2. It means, moreover, there is some value of P for which both these are equal. There is some value of P for the both of these will be the equal. That will be normally called as there is some value of probability that will between 0 and 1. Between 0 and 1, you will be indifferent between the alternative. Then they will be balanced to each other, or normal referred as a difference value. Right now, because we are discussing about the fundamental concept for the expected utility, whereas the original problem is very complex. As mentioned, that these utility concept will be used for the casino in which million of the dollar, yearly billion of the dollar people they will spend for the gaming. Moreover, for the insurance companies, these insurance companies use the utility theory. So it is not so easy. It's very, very difficult. But we are discussing about the fundamental concepts over there. As simple as there are some value of P for which these two will be balanced to each other. We need to identify what are these values. Now let's talk about the year. For example, here they mention about the what is the value of P of 0.7. Suppose value of P for 0.7. And so let's see, it means for the utility Rij is equal to 100 for the value of 100. And we have to alternate number 1, it is for the surety. Alternate number 2 is for the probability, in which we were given these are the table given us for the payoff table given us for the D1 and D2, D1 and D2 given us for the S1 and S2. So let's see, for example, as is mentioned, utility for the we need to, these are the utility for the surety, which is equal to 100. And suppose we were given, suppose we need to identify for the 0.7. For the 0.7, as we familiar that we were given here the property, this property is for the for p equals to 1, we have the maximum value, and for p equals to 0, this is for the minimum value. The minimum value, the utility for the minimum value, the utility for the minimum value is, this is the equation we formulated, utility for the 100 for the surety is equal to 0.7. We need to find is equal to 0.7, in which we have a utility of 150. What is utility of 150? Is equal to 1. As I just mentioned, we were given the maximum value and the minimum value, and this is the utility for the minimum, which is equal to 0. Which is equal to 0. Then, solving for this one is equal to 0.7 multiplied by 1 plus 0.2 multiplied by 0 is equal to 0. Then equal to 0.7. It means we identified that the at p equals to 0.7, both alternative number 1 and alternative number 2, they have something, the probability of indifference. It means they will be balanced. We cannot make the differentiate or they will be or equal to or differentiate alternate number 1 and alternate number 2 at the probability value of p, which is right now for our case equal to 7. So the what I need to mention in this slide, that we need to identify what is the value for the probability at which there is any difference between them. Now, until now in the previous slides, we talk about the what is the basic concept for the utility. Now let's try to cover up with the example. As the highest noted, please have a look of this table and please keep this in your mind, so that otherwise okay, noted, these are the payoff value. We are using this payoff value throughout our chapter. Some payoff value will be given to us there. What is the minimum value for this table? The minimum value is -600. Okay, what is the maximum value? The maximum value for this payoff table is equal to 500. No, please note this one. Moreover, what is the then rest of the values? They started from the -100 and ended up to the 500. Here, the basic concept for the we have the basic concept as the for the minimum value, the utility value is 0. For the maximum value, the utility value is 1. And we need to identify what are the rest of the value pure for the rest of the pure value, that is -100, 100, 200, 300, whatever the value, what is the corresponding utility value for this pure value? What is the corresponding utility value? Please note it, this table in your mind. The highest value, the highest payoff is 500. The lowest payoff is 100. For the highest payoff, the utility value is 1. For the lowest payoff, the utility value of is 0. Which Ahmed would occur if he invested in company B, and they have a large fall in the market. Means, as we saw in the respective value in the previous, as I show the table in which maybe the scenario is he will make the investment for the company B. Then the second highest value is 300. As I told you, the second highest value is 300. The case of the gold and the large fall in the market. Let me show you. For example, what does it mean? Yes. Yes, for the large rise, investment for the large rise, investment in company B. For the small rise, investment in company C. For no change, investment gold, etc. So these are the. It does not make the relation. Just want to understand. Yes, investment in company B. and the second largest was 300 the investment in the gold. We asked Ahmed if he would receive our, suppose we want to formulate the for the utility value for the same problem as we discussed throughout this chapter. If we can ask Ahmed if you could receive 300 for the sure, it means we were given utility of 300, which is in the payoff. We need to convert this 300 into payoff or 300, or you could receive 500 with the probability of P, 500 for the probability of P, and minus 600 for the loss of minus 600 for the loss of 1 minus P. What is the value of P that will make you in difference between them? So we need to formulate they remember some value of P, for which then it means some value of P. Obviously, it will, the balance should be in the we go for the probability for some other value of P. The Ahmed will choose for the surety. There must be some value of P for which both of them, alternate number one, alternate number two, either the surety or the probability, they will make the indifference between them. So we need to identify what is the value of P that make the indifference between them. Somehow he will get this indifference value by which are given as. So first step is we will make all of the payoff values should be in the ascending order from the minimum to the maximum. The minimum value is minus 600, the maximum value is 500. And these, as I show you in the previous table, somehow just make them in the ascending order. The minimum value should be given as 0, the maximum value should be given as 1. What about the rest of this value? These are the rest of the values for the probability, which will make the equivalence with the payoff value. You are not required to compute, you are not required to know how do we compute these values of the probability. We are not required. In the exam, I will give the these similar, I will give to you. You are not required to compute what are the value that make them in difference between them. Ahmed wishes to determine the optimal investment decision. So that Ahmed want to determine what is the optimal decision, either investment company A, company B, company C, gold, etc. So as I mentioned, all of the payoff value for the certainty, they are the certainty value, arrange them in ascending order from the minimum to the maximum. Minimum is 600, if 0 correspond to 0, the maximum is 500, the corresponding 1. These are the sum of the values, they are in between them. All of this value, they are in between them. Then with these payoff value need to be converted into the utility value. So this is beyond your scope. How do we get this value? Or some theory they are applied, a theory they apply that will convert them for conversion from these payoff value to corresponding. What you need to do, just the same table. We have the five alternative, gold, investment in gold, investment in company A, company B, company C. We have five state of the nature. What are these? Large rise, small rise. No change, small fall, large fall. Moreover, we were given the probability. These are the probability were given to us. Okay? These are the probability were given to us. We just replace the payoff value. These are the payoff value, which we need to replace with the corresponding utility values. They are the, for example, in the previous, some value were there. We just replace from the table the payoff value to the utility value. This is a simple step. You are not required to compute how do we get this one. Just replace them. For example, as we identified, the minimum value is 600. So here, maybe in the table, the value is 600. The maximum value is 500. So in the table, the payoff table, the maximum value 500 is written here. Just replace them. What you need to compute, you will need to compute the expected utility. These are expected utility. If the formula is the same, that the probability, these are the probability multiplied by the corresponding. Previously we have the payoff value, here we have the utility value. Previously we have the payoff value. This multiplied by this, in the same way this multiplied by this, make a summation. So this is the expected utility for the gold, expected utility for the company A, company B, company C. Then what is the maximum value? The maximum value is the investment company B. because it has the highest gain, highest utility. Aspect utility company investment B because it is the highest utility. So noted this slide that whatever the payoff value given to you, a conversion time similar to this one will also be given to you. What you just need to replace the payoff value with the utility values similar to this one, and the same, the address of the step, they are the same. You will compute the expected utility, the optimal decision with the highest utility. Attitude toward life in the utility along with the probability that will be included. There are three types of Vardhyan: risk averser or risk averser, risk taker. Some of the decision manager, they are risk taker. They are risk taker means whenever they find the opportunity, they can take the risk. Obviously, when you do the business, maybe you will have the profit and loss. Some of the this lifestyle of the decision maker, when they find a little bit opportunity and they want to avail this opportunity, and they are optimistic about their, or in the word, because they're risk taker. Second one is about the type of the decision maker who are risk averse, who want to try to avoid to taking the risk. They are the decision maker. They try to avoid to taking the risk. Then it will be categorized as the risk averse. Third one is a risk normal. For the risk normal is neither they were the optimistic or the risk averse or risk taker. They were in between them. Let's see what are the properties were there, and when we discuss in perspective for the utility concept. In the previous slide, we were talking about the two types were there: payoff value and the utility value. Payoff value and the utility value. So here for the risk avoidance, but they will prefer the payoff value to the utility. They will prefer the payoff for the utility. On the other hand, for the risk taking means someone found a little bit opportunity, they want to avail this opportunity, they always take the risk. They will prefer the utility as compared to the payoff for the payoff. So prefer a certain outcome payoff to a certain outcome utility. It means they always prefer the payoff as compared to the utility for the case of risk averse, having the same expected value. Other cases, the reverse of the number one. Third one is about the indifference between the chance outcome and the certain outcome. This is the chance outcome and the certain outcome. Chance outcome means utility, and the certain outcome is they are the payoff. So there is indifference between them. They referred as a risk neutral when they have the same value, having the same expected value. Now when we draw the graph, then risk averse means they try to avoid to take any risk, and moreover, what they prefer the payoff as compared to the utility. The graph is look like that one. So in other words, we can say concave curve. This is a concave curve. Utility rises slower. This utility, the rises slower than the payoff. Then the payoff increases much more. For example, here. Whereas the second type is known as the risk seeker, have the convex curve. Utility rises faster. This utility faster than the payoff. The third one is about the risk neutral. This concept is in other words, we can say for the risk averture to avoid the risk, then the graph is something concave. As compared to the convex is the graph, then convex graph is used for the risk seeker. Risk neutral is a straight line. Now let's do the example so that it's more clear for us for the expected utility. Consider the following three state: state 1, state 2, state 3. Three state of the nature for decision: D1, D2, D3, D4, four alternative were there. which of the following pay off in real? These are the pay off value. Some pay off value for some 100,000, 40,000 minus 60, they are some pay off value. As we saw in the rest of the chapter, for example, in the rest of the chapter, we identify the similar problem. For example, we identify the similar, some pay off are given to us. Okay, then we have the corresponding state of the nature along with the corresponding alternative. The probability, then we were also given the probabilities. Probability for S1, S2, and S3 as the probability for three state of the nature are 0.1, 0.3, and 0.6. These are the probabilities over there. So in this slide, just what were they given? Just pair value with the state of the nature corresponding to different alternatives with the probability. What we need to do? First, how do we compute the risk neutral? Risk neutral. In the risk neutral, as we saw in the previous, just probability will be multiplied by the state of the nature. Probability multiplied by the pay off value. These are the pay off value. What we just do, just make the multiplication for the probability, as you say, and find the what are the expected value. -14,000, -7,000, and 2,000. Which one has the highest value? The highest value will be given as D3. 2000 is the value, highest value. Rest of the value, they are negative. And the optimal decision is make the investment in the D3 because it is the highest value. Note that expected value D of need not to be calculated as the decision force is dominated by the decision D2. Similar, for example, in the previous lecture, we talk about when we create the problem scenario, sometimes we have very large number of alternatives were there. Some of these alternatives can be dominated, can be covered up by the rest of the option, rest of the alternative. So we can ignore them. In the same way, they ignore the D4 in the previous, and because it's already dominated by D4. So it means right now we have a simplified version in which we need to make the calculation D1, D2, D3. Then out of this one, because the highest value is 2000, rest of the values they are negative. So the optimal decision for the investment in the D3. Very simple one. They are the very simple one. Now let's talk about the make the decision maker with different utilities. Now again, as we saw, for the same payoff, they are the payoff values from the maximum to the minimum. Minimum value should be given as the utility of 0. The maximum value should be given as utility of 100. Or in other words, in the previous slide, we talk about the from 0 to 1. Or when we scale up, or 0% or 100%, or when we scale up, then we can say 0 to 100, doesn't matter. But the important thing is we identified the minimum value, maximum value. The minimum payoff will be nothing. It is clear to us. Here we have the two different type of decision maker were there. Decision maker number one, decision maker number two, or two manager were there. Manager Ahmed, manager Saad, for example. Okay. Then we need to make the analysis. Who is the risk avoidance, and who is the person who take the risk? Who want to take the risk? Who does not want to take the risk? What we need to do? These are the payoff, rest of the payoff value from the previous table. These are the payoff value. For example, here, these are the payoff value. For this payoff value, somehow we were given the utility. These somehow given the utility. Okay. These are given corresponding utility for the decision maker one and the decision maker two. The corresponding utilities were given to us. Somehow they were given to us. That's why in the exam, a conversion table I will give you in the exam for the utility and the payoff I will give to you. It doesn't, so you are not required to how do we get these values. But you what we need to do, we want to make the calculation or draw the graph. Suppose we are drawing the graph for the decision maker one and decision maker two. Between the what are the variables were there? Here we have the payoff. Here we have the utility. Here we have the payoff. 100,000, 50,000, 40,000, they want to draw this graph. These are the P of x axis, y axis, we okay, can you hear me now? Yes. So here in this slide, what we have, we plot the, okay, yes. In this slide, we plot the monetary value or the payoff value, monetary value, payoff value, whatever you can give the name, the other, in the y-axis, payoff value. In term of 100, all of this value will be in the 1000 form, 100,000 from, okay. And here in the y-axis, we have, what are the values we have? We have the utility values, utility. When you draw the graph for the decision, graph for the decision maker one, this is the graph for decision maker two. So this is graph is the concave. Concave means the type of the attitude for the decision maker one is something avoiding the risk. Whenever about this, what about this one? The type is something convex. Convex means whenever he find a little bit opportunity, he will take the risk between them. So these are the graph shows the decision maker utility curves were there. Now let's do the example. Suppose we were given three states of the nature. The same example, three states of the nature is S1, S2, S3, state 1, state 2, state 3 for the then. We also have the three decision or optimal decision or alternative D1, D2, D3. What we need to do that we want to make the calculation for the decision maker 1. The first step is we will convert this graph, whatever the value do we have. These are the value we have. We will convert this value we will convert this value to the corresponding utility value. Maximum value, for example, the maximum value is here. We find the maximum values. This is the maximum value, and this will be for some okay. So for the decision maker one, these are the these are the payoff value. They are these. It is his utility value. So just convert this graph. Just convert this graph. It will be neglected into the corresponding values, corresponding utility values here. So for example, here we say for the here we have 100,000. It will be converted with the table as 100,000 will be converted as 100. We are right now we are doing for the number one. So just convert them. So in this slide, what we were given, just convert these. Previously it was the payoff value. Right now convert into the utility value. How do we convert? A conversion graph is given to you. Just see the corresponding value and fill up this graph. Moreover, these properties they were given to you. Next step is find the expected utility. How do we compute expected utility as this multiplied by this, make a summation. We found the expected utility is 37. In the same way, we also need to compute the expected utility for the D2 and the expected utility for the D3. Then the corresponding expected utility are 57.4 and 68. Now, which one is the highest value? the highest value is 68 because the rest of the value they are small. So it means the corresponding decision should be the optimal decision by the for the decision maker one. So decision maker one, what he will do? He will make the option for the investment in D3, or D3 is the optimal decision because it is the highest expected utility. Now that's if these are the for the decision maker one. It means following the decision maker one, we will follow this utility will given to us. Now let's talk about the decision utility for the decision maker two. These are the, for example, here for the 50,000, the corresponding utility for the decision maker one is 94. Here the corresponding utility for the decision maker two is 58. So now let's talk about let me show. Yes, let's talk about the expected utility for the decision maker two. What you need to do? Just replace the expected the PO value with the corresponding utility value from the chart or table given to you. Number one, then we will compute the expected utility. How do we compute the expected utility? Probability multiplied by corresponding PO value multiplied and make a summation is equal to 22.3 and 24.8. Which one has the highest value? Highest value is 25 and the corresponding decision is D1. The corresponding decision will be D1. So it means optimal decision is D1 for the decision maker 2. Whereas for the decision maker 1, it was D3. Now let's talk about the another case for the indifference between them. Who is neither optimistic, pessimistic, something between them. Let me, we have computed, let me check, yes. For the indifference between them, neutral, either you can use the expected value or the utility, it doesn't matter, because as we saw, the basic property for the basic property is, we as we found, the for the low PO value, the corresponding utility value will be low. For the highest PO value, the corresponding utility value will be high. That's why minus 600, which is the lowest value, has the corresponding utility value of 0. Then 500, which is the highest PO value, should have the corresponding utility of the 100. So this is the for the risk neutral case. Okay, we have done this one. Now we want to make the analysis. Suppose the probability for the three star of the nature in this example was changed. Previously, we were given 0.1. These are the probabilities were there. Previously, 0.1, 0.3, 0.6. Suppose we change the probability. Now, we want to make the analysis. What are the changes do we have? 0.5, 0.3, 0.2. What is the optimal decision for the risk neutral? And what's the optimal decision for the risk maker 1-1 and for the risk decision maker 2? And what is the value of the decision problem to the decision maker? Now we also need to find the value. Obviously today I cannot compute the value. I will compute the value of the decision maker 1 and 2 to the next lecture. I will make a little bit overview, and what are the conclusions you draw for this value. For this one, I will discuss in the next lecture. Okay. In this slide, we just change the probability and find out now either the optimal decision was changed or does not change. Changing the probability, it is identified the corresponding. These are the corresponding expected utility or the PO value. As I told you, for the risk neutral, either you can use the PO or the utility. It doesn't matter. So here they did not convert the PO value. They just directly use the they convert it into the utility value. They just directly use the PO value. And what is the maximum value? The maximum value is 50,000. It means the optimal decision for the neutral decision maker is the make the investment changing the probability. Let's talk about what is the optimal decision for that decision maker 1 and decision maker 2. Because of the changing of the probability, now it is highest value is expected utility is 79. It means changing the probability, he changed his decision. The optimal decision is D2. Optimal because it is the highest utility. But as I mentioned that these are the utility value. How can we get this value? The pure value from the table, conversion table, will be from the conversion table change the payoff to the utility from the conversion table. What about the decision maker 2? For the decision maker 2, because it has the highest payoff, it is a higher utility, is correspond to the D1, corresponding to the T1, then it is 65, his optimal decision should be D1. For the changing of this probability. So in other words, we can say we can create some conversion table. Based on the conversion table, the software financial companies or application were there, you just enter one time the probability, then they will create the table, the graph, whatever the report automatically, and automatically it will change the probability or change the report whatsoever. So I think okay, I will discuss. Okay, actually it's required to for the one. Okay, I will leave this one because it's required. It will be 5 to 10 minutes will be required to discuss about the what are the corresponding values were there. What are the corresponding values were there? It means how can we convert back from the utility to the corresponding payoff. This is in this line we will discuss later on. Because it required a little bit of time. One more thing about the especially for example for the quiz number 2 and quiz number 3, we found I think some of these students or I received for example the student that they have the conflict for conflict of time. For the quiz number 2 and quiz number 3. So please note that all of your quizzes will be taken during the lecture time. So please note this one. I have already updated in the LMS. Again, I'm emphasizing quiz number 2 and quiz number 3. The dates, they are the same. But the time will not be at 5 o'clock in the afternoon or in the evening, but during the lecture time. Moreover, you are also again emphasizing that especially before the any of your exam, any of the please see the LMS. If there is any update, you can see in the LMS. Please note this point. Don't say, doctor, I don't know, because I have already updated the LMS. Moreover, during the lecture time, I also mentioned that all of your quizzes will be during the lecture time. One more time, Faisal is there? Faisal?
Yes.
I'm talking about who is Faisal, who has the conflict of that in the midterm exam. Any update or not?
We did the Google Sheet.
Okay.
And
what is it?
What?
Is there any update or not?
Yeah. We discussed about with the student about changing okay. the time. And,
okay.
When we did the Google Sheet and we asked about the days that have a mid-exam, and we okay. found we found if we change the time, we change the day, maybe it's much better.
What is the date?
The same week 8. It's in Wednesday, not Thursday.
Okay, then the point is, Faisal, the point is all of these students should be agree. If any of these students does not agree, then we will do something else. You are getting my point?
For
example, when all of the students they are agree, that's the best way. If any of these students, for example, might be possible, you send me the date, and I forward your proposed date to the examination committee. Later on, one of the students claim, no, I have this type of problem, this problem. Then it will be difficult. If you can do best one, okay, I will make this request, forward your request to the examination committee. If it is not somehow any reason you cannot find, then I will do something else. Get my point?
Yeah, the vote was for all the student vote.
Yes, what I require, all you should agree. If you are unable to make them, all of them agree, then obviously for your exam, I will do something else. Might be possible need to take makeup exam sometime later. Okay, but it's a good thing that we will have the exam for all of the students. Okay, you are getting my point. All of the students agree, that's best. For as you mentioned about the, for example, the Wednesday, if you have completed your polling, that will be sent to me. I will forward. Yeah, the point is, I am relying on you. I am relying on you. What you send me, maybe one time I will send again to the rest of the students. All of them agree, that's best. If you did not make convince or the consensus, all of them, then I will do something else. Okay, get it?
Yeah, okay.
Okay, now you may leave the session. So thanks of you. Thank you very much. Okay, doctor, we will ask all the students to vote. If the point, if they will ask the vote, that's the good one. Otherwise, I will give you option number two. Option number two is, I will take the exam for the rest of the student on the same day, that is on the Thursday at 5 o'clock. And for you, I will, before the end of the exam, I will take your exam, make your exam, take your exam individual. Okay, because you have the conflict of exam. Okay.
Wait, I didn't understand. My exam in different time.
No, for example, if for example you did not find, you cannot make the consensus, all of the students they did not agree on the date, you find something difficult. What the next option number two for me? Option number two for me is, I will take the exam for all remaining students on the same date and same time, that is Thursday at 5 o'clock. And for you, I will prepare a makeup exam, but I will take your makeup exam before the final exam. I will give some time, then I will take your makeup exam later on. Now got it?
Okay.
If that's why it is my habit, from the day one I announce the date for all of the quizzes, all of the midterm exam, all of the assignment. So that's why we don't have any problem. But maybe you did not follow, or maybe when Dr. Khalil Al-Hindi, he has two sections. You told he has three sections. No, he does not have three sections. He has two sections. Moreover, as you mentioned that he had the computer science department told. Computer science department does not told them. It is the instructor whose responsibility is convey the date, make the consensus. But anyhow leave this one. So thanks of you. Thank you very much. Now you may leave the session.